common mark all around. Everybody's having a great time. Smack it!
Welcome. My focus question is, to what extent did the implementation of the Hays Code on movies during the 1950s have an effect on society's views of women, their behavior, and the concept of sexuality? The making of motion pictures started back in the early 1900s. It started when photographer Edward Muybridge made a bet with Leland Stanford that while a horse was running, all of its legs left the ground at one point. He proved this by stringing 12 cameras together on a rig, and while the horse would be running by, it would trigger all the cameras and would take the photos in sequence. In the end, Edward was proven right, and he accidentally created the world's first motion picture. Let's flash forward to the 1920s, a time of few restrictions. I got to interview Redwood's own Mr. Manhondo about what that time was like for the movie industry.
For about a 17-year period after D.W. Griffith's Birth of a Nation, films just exploded across the country. And because more people were making films, people just made whatever they wanted to. And as a result of that, you know, if you think about specifically like film really coming of age during the Roaring Twenties was an age of excess. So films, much like literature, are a product of their times. And so the films made during the 20s showed a lot of excess, and that's excess in drugs and sex and relationships and all sorts of things that went outside of sort of, you know, quote-unquote mainstream America.
During this time, women were finding new ways to express autonomy. A staple of the 1920s were flappers, girls who kept their hair and skirts short, girls who drank, did drugs, and engaged in premarital relationships. Then, everything changed in the 1930s when the Hays Code was put into effect. The Hays Code, also known as the Motion Picture Production Code, was a set of strict guidelines on what films could show.
There was an organization in the country called the Catholic League of Decency. And the Catholic League of Decency comes along and they basically say to Hollywood, look, if you don't start regulating and censoring your films, every Sunday at church, we're going to have our priest basically say, like, you cannot go see X, Y, and Z films because they are outside the realm of, like, moral decency.
And so, the Hays Code was put into effect. The code restricted scenes of violence, use of drugs, but most especially, scenes regarding sex.
What directors and screenwriters and all sorts of people would have to do is figure out how to be more suggestive, how to utilize innuendo as a way to achieve the same goal.
Let's move forward to the 1950s. More white families were moving to the suburbs, people were having more children, and there was rampant sexism. Women were forced by society to go back to their traditional roles. It was rare to see a woman working outside of the home. Their focus was supposed to be on their family.
You know how old I was when I got married? 17. My mother almost had a fit. You're just a baby, she said. Well, anyway, a year later, I had a real baby. This baby. I was scared stiff. Not just because I never had a baby before, but I had to prove something to my mother and my mother-in-law. I was going to be the world's best mother.
In 50s advertisements, women were only shown in ads regarding household matters, like drugs, detergent, cleaning supplies, or vacuum cleaners. It is also thought that a woman's main goal was to please a man, and that she did everything she did for him. In film, it was no different, but it was slightly more misogynistic than sexist. I found some examples of overt misogyny in 50s films. Here's a scene from Some Like It Hot.
I used to sing with male bands, but I can't afford it anymore.
Have you ever been with a male band?
Who? Me?
That's what I'm running away from. I worked with 6 different ones the last 2 years.
Oh,
rubbish. Rob? I'll say.
You can't trust those guys.
I can't trust myself. I have this thing about saxophone players, especially tenor sax.
Really?
I don't know what it is, but they just curdle me. All they have to do is play 8 bars or Come to Me, My Melancholy Baby, and my spine turns to custard. I get goose pimply all over, and I come to them.
That's all?
Every time.
You know, I play tenor sax.
But you're a girl, thank goodness.
Here's one from All About Eve.
Then you two must have a long talk.
I'm afraid Mr. DeWitt would find me boring before too long.
You won't bore him, honey. You won't even get a chance to talk.
Claudia, come here. You see that man? That's Max Fabian, the producer. Now go and do yourself some good.
Why do they always look like unhappy rabbits?
Because that's what they are. I've got to make him happier. Now, don't worry about your little charge. She'll be in safe hands.
This last one is from My Fair Lady.
In Hartford, Hereford, and Hampshire, hurricanes hardly ever happen.
In Hartford, Hereford, and Hampshire, hurricanes hardly ever happen.
Oh, no, 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 no. Have you no ear at all?
Shall I do it over?
No, please. Start from the very beginning. Just do this. Go, ha, 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 ha.
Ha, 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 ha.
Go on, go on, go on.
Ha, ha.
Since more and more people had access to motion pictures during this time, it's safe to assume that motion pictures had an effect on the public. Since women were portrayed in misogynistic or sexist manners, we can assume that the public may have thought that women should behave that way outside of the silver screen. Though a different scene from Some Like It Hot is the only one that really addresses that issue. Though it is technically men who explain it.
Elevator. Now you know how the other half lives.
Look at that, I'm not even pretty.
They don't care, just so long as you're wearing a skirt. It's like waving a red flag in front of a bull.
Really? Well, I'm sick of being the flag. I want to be a bull again.